Hi, it's Paul. I'm taking another look at the introduction to function block diagram, and this time I'm going to focus mostly on the differences between ladder logic and function block diagram. Let's take a look at my scene here. I've got my parking lot system, and I did a little bit of ladder logic. I've only programmed it to count cars coming in. So let's take a look at my logic. Here at the top, I've got my car arrive sensor. So that's this guy here when a car comes. That's going to start a timer for 3 seconds, and the timer is going to latch itself on. It's going to seal itself in so that it keeps running even when I take my finger off the button. While that timer's running, this OK to enter light should light. The next thing that's going to happen is when I push this car arrive sensor, it's going to increase this count up. And then lastly, I need to use either a copy command or a move command to move the value out of this counter and move it into an integer out so I can actually display that value on my display. Okay, let's take a look at my tags. Here's the tags. So I've got two counters in here. I'm only using the first one right now. I've got a timer tag, and then I've got all my Boolean inputs and outputs and a couple integer outputs. Now, I had to create all these tags manually. So if you want to use a counter, first you have to create a tag for the counter, and then you can do something with the counter. You can either make it increase or decrease or move the value or do whatever with it. Same with timers. You have to create the tag and then you can go do something with it. So let's look at my main routine, see if this works. When I push my car arrive sensor, it should lock on this timer, run the blue light, and increase my counter to 1. And it did that. So my logic is working. Everything's happy. Now let's take a look at how I would do that in function block to do those same things. So I'm going to go offline. And the first thing I need is I need another routine for function block. So I'll right click on the main task. I'm sorry, on the main program. And I'm going to add a new routine. I need to make sure that this guy is function block. And I need to call it something, so I'll just call it FBD Logic. Good enough. Okay, so now I have two routines. One is called the main routine. That's automatically created when you open a project. And I made a second one called function block. With this second routine, it's never going to run because my main routine doesn't have any jump to subroutine for that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to properties in my main program, and under configuration it says assign routines. The main one is main routine. I'm going to change it to that new one I just made. Now when I run my logic, it's only going to run this function block routine. Okay. I need some inputs, some outputs, and I need some logic going on. If you look at the top here, these guys, and I clicked that twice, those are inputs, and beside it are outputs. And then there's some other things that we're not going to deal with just yet. So I only want one input. I've got my input, and that's going to be my car arrive sensor. And the outputs I used last time, I used that OK to enter. And I used cars and lot, so I'll get another output. Okay, those are the outputs I used last time. Let me double check. So I've got my OK to enter, and I've got my cars and lot. I've got two outputs going. And just one input is all I'm using right now. The first thing I did before is I started a timer. So I'm going to do that in function block. Now to do a timer, it's quite different. I don't have to create a tag for my timer. All I have to do is go over to timers. Over a bit more. There we go. Here's timers and counters. And I want a TONR, timer on. Now I put that on my sheet. I'll go back to my tags. And here's that tag for that timer. So Studio 5000 created that tag for me. I don't have to worry about that. Okay, there's my timer. I'm going to start it with this car arrive sensor. And that's my timer enable. Now last time I used the timer to seal itself on, and I want to do that again. I don't see my TT output, so I have to turn that on. I'll click on the ellipses and turn on TT. The TT still runs, it's just it wasn't displayed. And now I displayed it. There's my TT, and I got nothing to hook that to latch it on, so that's not going to work yet. The other thing that you're going to become very familiar with function block is a reset dominant. So I'm just going to right click anywhere on the screen, add element, and I'm going to type RESD. So reset dominant. And don't worry about the word dominant, it's just if you get both set and reset, if they're both hot, then the reset is dominant. So you don't really need to worry about that. Basically, this is to seal in the logic. Okay, I'll delete that connector. This is getting a little crowded. All right, my car arrive sensor is going to set this seal in. The output's going to go to my timer enable. And the done bit is going to connect to my reset. Next thing you need to always keep track of in function block is if you make a loop, then it doesn't know where to start. So here I have a loop between these connectors. I have to tell it where to start, and to do that you simply right click on the line and say assume data available. That's the start here command. So that's good. My timer is on. While my timer's on, I'm going to hook my timer timing to my OK to enter. That's going to turn on that blue light while the timer's going. Let's see what else I did in my other logic. So I've got my timer. It seals on while the timer timing. While the timer is timing, it's going to light that light. Then I've got this car arrive sensor going to a counter. Let's put that in. All right, I need a counter, so I'll go to timers and counters, and I'll do a CTUD, count up down. And let me check my tags, and there's my count up down. There's my reset dominant, and made a tag for that too, although I'm not really going to use that. Okay, when my car arrives, I want to count up. And then I want to hook my accumulate to the cars in the lot. I don't have to do any move command or copy command. I just hook it up there. And I think I've got everything from my original logic. I've got my counter now. This move command I don't need because I just hook my connector from the ACC to that output, and everything looks good. Let's go online and take a look at it. And it's downloaded. I'm going to just disconnect and reconnect factory IO to make sure it has the right connection. And I think I got some errors. So if you look at the bottom here, it says warning, main routine cannot be reached by main routine. So it's given me a warning that this FBD logic is my main routine and there's nothing to send it over to this main routine because I'm not using that anymore. So that's okay. And the other is I've got duplicate destructive bits. What it's not happy about is in here, in this routine, I've got my OK to enter, my output, and in this routine, I also have OK to enter. So I've used my outputs twice, and you can't do that. You can only use an output one time, even if it's in different routines. But because I'm not accessing that other routine, it should still work. Let's have a look. And it's working. So you see my car arrive sensor goes hot. Now it doesn't turn green, it just tells me with this update that that 0 went to a 1. And while my timer's accumulating, my timer timing should light this blue light. And it's doing it. I did something wrong because it's going on and resetting. I think it's being affected by that main routine. So I've got something wrong in my logic, but that's fine. I can go back and fix that. That's what PLC programming is all about. You set up your routine, you go online, you test it, and then you see what's not working, and you go back offline and you fix it. Okay, so those are the main differences between ladder logic and function block. With ladder logic, I had to first create my tags, and then I could do things like count up and turn on a timer. With function block, I don't have to create those tags first. I just put my block in and start using it. Reset dominant is very common. You're going to get used to using that a lot. Timers and counters. The other ones you're going to use a lot are the Boolean OR and the Boolean AND. So we call them a BOR and a BAND. And I'll just go, well, first I got to go offline. I'll put in a BAND and I'll put in a BOR. All right, they're very similar. It's just BAND, Boolean AND. You need to have any of the inputs you hook up to it need to be hot in order to get your output. And a BOR, Boolean OR, you have to have only one of those inputs go hot to get the output. So it's series logic and parallel logic. The other one you're going to get very familiar with is a NOT. And all that does is it switches a hot to a cold and a cold to a hot. So if I want to use this done bit, I should have used a B NOT. A Boolean NOT. Now I can hook this done bit to the input, and I can hook my output to some light or something. So those are the main function blocks you're going to use. The BAND and the BOR for AND and OR, the B NOT, and counters and timers. Okay, let's get started. Talk to you soon.